Cooked with Chef Jason Peru is brought to you in part by
Welcome back to Cooked. Sometimes it gets me off guard singing. So let's get started with our first dish. It's a roasted pumpkin and ricotta ravioli. Now don't get scared. Ravioli is just basically a type of pasta fold. And we're going to use the wonton skins today to mimic that. And wonton skins, as we mentioned earlier on, are very convenient and easily sourced. So don't need to go and make fresh pasta. Another ingredient that you're going to be using is the ricotta cheese. This is actually a sheep's milk cheese. Very creamy, luscious, very rich. And I think it's going to be an excellent filling when we pair it with our roasted pumpkin earlier on. We have just some simple household crackers. We have these at home at all the time. Some onions. We're going to julienne these in a little while. These are going to help with the binding for the filling. Now this is an interesting herb. You don't see this used quite often these days. It's actually sage. It has a sort of a musty scent, but when it hits that hot butter, it's so fragrant, it just transforms. Cranberries are actually a favorite of mine. They're dried, they're intensely sweet, and when you pair it with the butter, it's just so mesmeric in the atmosphere. And of course, a little bit of crunch there. I have walnuts today, chopped walnuts, about 2 tablespoons of chopped walnuts. First and foremost, I have about 1/4 pound of pumpkin. I'm gonna dice this up. The beauty about this is that it doesn't matter how you dice it because it's all going to puree later on. So what I'm doing is actually dicing it up right now. I'm going to put it into this bowl. So what I want to do is just basically a medium dice. You can go smaller, but the smaller you cut it, it tends to leach out a lot of the, you know, the nutritional value. So here I go, my pumpkin. I have some rosemary. Rosemary is just one of those nice woody herbs that you could actually smell from a mile away. I have some basil and I have thyme. Now, you see the amount of thyme that I have here. I definitely wasted no time, eh? A little bit goes a long way. And what I want to do is just put all these herbs together. I just want to basically go over them very roughly with my knife. What I'm actually doing here is actually called rock chopping by actually bringing the knife back and forth and scooping it and creating abrasion and cutting up into smaller pieces. Gonna put this inside of our pumpkin. To that, I wanna add a little bit of vegetable oil. Maybe like about 1 tablespoon. A little bit of salt. A little bit of black pepper, maybe like about 1/2 teaspoon each. Now, there are certain flavors that are very conversant with each other when cooking. Nutmeg and pumpkin is like the Romeo and Juliet of culinary words. They go together so well, even cinnamon. So we're gonna mix this up together. Black pepper, salt, nutmeg, rosemary, basil, thyme, and our beautiful pumpkin inside here. Now as I mix this up, what I wanna do is definitely put this to roast. Remember, it is roasted, so I'm gonna put it on a pan like that. As you can see, all this beautiful basil, the thyme inside there. And when you roast this up, the sweetness of the pumpkin is going to come out. So I have my oven set at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. Let's go put it in. I took the liberty earlier on to have some done. After about 20 to 25 minutes, this is what it looks like. As you can see, the pumpkin is a little squinched. It's caramelized a little bit because pumpkin is actually sweet. And you can still see the rosemary and the basil. It's fragrant. So this is actually our roasted pumpkin. So while that sits there, we're gonna have the next component for our ravioli, which is actually sauteed onions. I've taken the liberty of actually cutting up one onion already. I have one more to cut up. And you would see that I left the root on the onion on. That helps to keep the layers intact so we don't cry. Sulfuric compounds in the onions that causes us to tear up. So I'm gonna be cutting these nice thin strips like that. I have a pan on the stove, a medium-sized pan, a little bit of vegetable oil, maybe like about 2 tablespoons. And the idea is that I'm gonna saute these onions up. Now you hear that little sizzle, that's great. Onions actually have a lot of sugar inside of it. If you ever heard the term caramelized onions, people eat it on top of mushrooms all the time and even on pizzas. That's what we're aiming here right now for. So what I'm gonna do is just basically stir this up and allow the natural sugars to caramelize. This is actually gonna go into our filling together with the pumpkin. I'm gonna add a little bit of salt to it, a little bit of black pepper. You could actually see that they're starting to get brown already. I'm gonna leave this for about 3 to 4 minutes again. Any household processor works very well. This is just a handy dandy one that I got. My roasted pumpkin goes inside here. As you can see that the pumpkin definitely leaches out a lot of its color, and that's good because we want to get that intensely yellow color in our filling. Ricotta cheese. I would average maybe like about 1/4 cup. Again, this is just for the creaminess. Just to bind it, remember we spoke about the crackers earlier on? The vital supplies, as we would refer to it as. And I want to just put this inside now and pulse it. At this point right now, I want to take my onions. I want to add it. Beautiful. Take off this, put it back on the stove. So as I process this, I'm just gonna add a little bit of black pepper and salt, and then we're gonna come back from a break. See you soon. So we're back. This is our finished product. I just emptied the processor, and this is the pureed pumpkin, ricotta, and the onions inside there, a little bit of black pepper and salt. You could still see all the herbs inside there, such as the rosemary and the basil that we originally roasted the pumpkin with earlier. So this is our beautiful filling. Time to fill. Now I have some wonton skins right here. You could use the eggless ones. You could use the ones with egg. It doesn't matter. To me, all of them react the same way. I have a little bit of water right here and a brush. And what I want to do is just basically paste a little bit of water on each wonton skin. And this will actually help create a seal when I fold it over in a little while. It's just like making wontons, except wontons have a fancier fold. This one I'm just doing in a triangle. Now we're going to take that beautiful filling that I made, put a little bit inside the center. Now try not to put too much, because what's going to happen is that it may actually open on you when you're cooking it. Less is more in this case. You could always make more ravioli. What I like about this is that you get those nice pieces of pumpkin inside there, so it still reminds you of what you're eating. And the creaminess of the cheese, it's beautiful. So check this out. Remember I said earlier on, we just brush it like that. If it's drying out on you, just put a little more water. And then you just fold it over like this, making sure to remove all of the excess air. If some oozes out, that's okay. Get it out. And we want to fold it over like that and create this nice seal. So I'm going to continue with the rest. But what's very important is that you seal these guys up, because when you put them in the hot water, if it's not sealed properly, all that beautiful filling actually comes out. And all, that's what we love. And that just drives me nuts. So make sure you spend the time to seal it. Better spend the time now rather than wait later on. All right, so here we go. We got our beautiful folded raviolis using our wonton skins. Nice and neat. And what I have here is just some water in a pan here. I added like about a teaspoon of salt earlier on, and it's very important that you boil it with salt so the wonton skins get some flavor. And I'm just gonna put them inside like this, gently. Think of it as like dumplings. When they rise to the top, they're ready. Now the average cooking time for this might take maybe like about 2 minutes to 2 minutes and a half. But as I say, when they come afloat and they break the surface, that's a good indication that they're ready. I'm using a perforated spoon because when I remove them in a little while, I want to make sure that I removed just the wonton and not the water. I've used ricotta and pumpkin today. I mean, you could use other fillings inside of this. You could use minced chicken inside here. Even like ground potato provisions together with maybe things like pork or beef works very well with a little bit of cheese. You get creative with this. So now removing them, these spent maybe like about 2 minutes inside there. And again, I'm using a perforated spoon, so I don't get any of that water inside there. Now we're gonna make this nice beurre noisette sauce. It's a fancy brown butter sauce. Let me get rid of this water. I'm gonna use the same pan back on the stove. And this goes by very quickly. What I wanna do, I wanna add some butter inside here. And the idea is that we wanna melt this butter and create a beautiful butter sauce for this. Beurre noisette basically means hazelnut butter, which is like nutty style butter. Hazelnut being the nut itself, so it's like very similar flavor profiles. Remember we spoke about sage earlier on? Well, I'm gonna pick the leaves, put them inside here. And you know, as soon as the sage hits the butter, it's like, oh my gosh. The best way to actually get these flavors of these herbs or these fresh herbs is to just put them in some butter sometimes. It's just so amazing on the palate and also on the nose. Some walnuts, cranberries. And the idea is just, I just want to toast these guys up now. And then I'm going to reinsert my skins back inside. At this point, add a little more butter, a little bit of salt, a little bit of black pepper. And that's it right there. What we're gonna do now is to plate this guy up. Put it down there like that. Sprinkle it all over just like that. And the final touch is we're gonna use a little bit of our Parmesan cheese on top. There we go. So this is what it is, the final. This is our ricotta and roasted pumpkin ravioli with beurre noisette, cranberries, and walnuts dusted with some Parmesan cheese on top. Let's take a try. The pumpkin is so creamy inside of it. Plus the walnuts just bring a whole element of flavor inside of it. The Parmesan cheese just kind of like binds on top of it. And it gives it that salty sort of flavor inside there. And the cranberries just peek through and give you that sweet kiss. I love it. So you know what? The next dish we're going to go on to is our pork shumai dumplings. When you come back, I'm going to show you how to make those using these same wonton skins. So we're back to uncook, and on the first dish, we did our pumpkin and ricotta ravioli. Second dish, shumai dumplings. I have a pan on the stove here with about 2 cups of water, and it's steaming right now. My bamboo steamer is on top. The water is simmering, more or less, so we're gonna put our dumplings inside there. Let's make the filling. I have about 1/2 cup of pork, minced pork that is. You could use minced chicken, minced shrimp. 3 tablespoons of minced portobello mushrooms, 1 tablespoon of garlic, 1 tablespoon of onion, 3 tablespoons of diced water chestnuts, 1 pimento minced, 1 tablespoon of chopped chives. I have 1 teaspoon of sesame oil and 2 tablespoons of soy sauce. The quintessential Asian seasoning. And what I want to do is mix this together like that. Add a little bit of salt inside there. Not too much because we have the soy sauce inside there. And the idea is to make this homogeneous. As it comes together like that, we add our last ingredient, 3 tablespoons of diced bodhi. Just want to make sure that the meat is minced and mixed properly. The coarser the grain, the better. Beautiful. Let's put that here for a while. Our handy dandy wontons. Very simple. Put them down on the board like that. I have 6. Use my brush, water. That's to make them pliable. Then I want to take the skins, put it inside my thumb and index like that, almost like making a cup. I'm going to take the meat, put like a tablespoon inside, push it down. A little more water on top. I want to push it down like that. I just like fold it over like this until you get this nice peak, just like that. Once you get that going on, we open up our steamer and put them in just like that. As you can see, the steam is coming up, and that's what we want. Let's try one more. Fold over. Nice peak. Put it inside there just like that. So I'm going to finish up with the rest of these. I got 4 more. And when we come back, we're going to start with our dessert. Alright, the dumplings ready. Check this out now. Check out that steam. We did 6 dumplings and they're beautifully steamed. If you're not sure if they're cooked, you could always do that internal temperature. Stick it into the meat if it registers at 140 degrees Fahrenheit and above, you're safe. But in the meantime, let's make a sauce for this because you can't eat dumpling without sauce. I have 2 tablespoons of sweet Thai chili and 1 tablespoon of extra dark soy sauce. So you have sweet and savory going on here. And this is very simple. Just a little bit of mixing there, and that's your dipping sauce. So let's plate up these bad girls. I have a nice plate. Take off my bamboo steamer. Whoopsie. And I want to lay them down like this. You see, they look a little nice and crumpled. I think that's a good characteristic of dumplings. A little wrinkle and stuff on it. It showed that, you know, it went through hard work to look good for you. And it's going to taste even better inside of your stomach. Look how we line up those guys, like a German army. Or we should say almost like a Chinese army. We take that nice sauce, drizzle it on top like that. You like plenty sauce. You know the average Trinidadian love sauce, eh? Put that down like that. Lay that here. And let's just jazz it up with a little bit of garnish. Chives, and you want to do a bias cut. Bias cut means to just cut it on the slant. And I think this really garnishes it up really nicely. Cashews also, but let's just keep it simple today. Now check this out. You don't have to go to any Chinese restaurant to get this done. Smoking our sweet Thai chili sauce and soy sauce, chives, and 6 beautiful dumplings just for me. Well, maybe I might share. We try these guys. Can't talk. Tweet me. Email me. All great things end with sweetness. We're gonna do a Nutella stuffed wonton. Nutella is actually hazelnut spread. It's almost very chocolatey. We're gonna do that with a nice banana foster topping. Coffee ice cream. Let's get started. Again, the star of the show, wonton skins. Put down about 4. And you realize that for every single application that I did, I'm just applying water on it. This helps to make it stick. Nutella! This is what I was telling you about earlier on. Chocolate hazelnut spread. I advise that you use it chilled, because if it's too soft, it might ooze out while it's frying. I use 2 spoons. One to take out, and the next one to disadhere it. And I mean, this is pretty strong itself, so you don't want to put too much inside of it. Again, creasing the edges, squeezing out the excess air from it. If you get air pockets inside of this, it's problematic because it puffs up, it bursts, and then all that beautiful prized Nutella is lost. But wait till you see what I have planned for this. After I fry these guys up, I'm going to show you how to make a bananas foster topping. Now what I want to do is take it, put it into the oil like that, and I want to fry it gently. Now as mentioned, these guys don't need much time frying at all. Once they start to turn light brown, that's it. Take them out. 1, 2, 3, 4. At this point right now, I have a little bit of powdered sugar inside here. I just want to tap it. Look at that. Just like snow. That by itself is beautiful and tasty. We're going to start with this banana now. One banana, I suggest you use one that is ripe, not overripe. Tends to be a little mushy. We are going to be cooking this. I want to cut it in half. Bananas are good for you, and they're high in potassium. And as a little boy, my mother force-fed me these. Now to the point where I'm like a little monkey. Eat bananas, probably one of my favorite fruits. I'm going to add a little bit of butter. About 2 tablespoons, 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. And the idea is that we want to make somewhat of a light caramel. I want to insert my bananas inside here. Now bananas cook very quickly, so this is going to go by lickety split. A dash of nutmeg. A dash of cinnamon. And of course, hey, we're in Trinidad, we're in the Caribbean. A teaspoon of dark rum. You hear the sizzle already down to the pot like it. And what we're actually making here is this nice sugar and butter sauce. And our bananas are cooking it, so it's nice and sweet. We just want to dissolve the sugar into the butter. Meanwhile, let's start to plate up. I have this nice plate here. I want to take my wontons. 1, 2, 3, 4. By this point, this will be ready. I have my coffee ice cream. I want a nice scoop. This is coffee ice cream I did earlier on. You could use vanilla ice cream, strawberry, chocolate. Just like the whole feel of coffee and banana. Take these beautiful bananas that I did. Spoon it on top. And then the last, you want to hit it with some powdered sugar again. Look at that. So to recap here, we have our Nutella stuffed wontons, our bananas Foster topping, coffee ice cream, just tad with a little bit of powdered sugar. I mean, just look at this. This is just a feast. I gotta taste it, of course. My fork here. No, I wanna get the perfect bite. You hear the crunch of the wontons and the ice cream together with the bananas. The ice cream adds that creaminess inside of it. It mellows it down. They play on the textures in terms of hot and cool. It's just like a party on your palate. And the bananas just add a little bit of mushiness inside there. All in all, it comes together very, very well. Coffee ice cream. Brilliant. This would actually go very well with vanilla ice cream too. I invite you to actually try this recipe. Actually, not only this one, but all the recipes that we did today. The pumpkin and the ricotta ravioli was a hit. The shumai dumplings is actually one of my favorites that I decided to share with you. But this dessert definitely brings it together. Even if you have a party at home or to meet some friends, it doesn't really take that much work. It's just some simple wontons and some simple ingredients. I mean, you could even get creative with this and be innovative yourself. Try different fillings, play around with it. Look what I did and I brought forward for you. And I mean, even if you try these things, share it with me. I'm out there on the social media. You could post it to my Instagram, @ChefJasonPeru. Put it on my wall on Facebook. Tweet me, even on YouTube. Make your videos and show it to us. Use #cooked, #CTV. I mean, when you make beautiful food like this, you gotta share it with the world, just like what I did here today. So you know what? Until the next episode of Cooked, it's your boy Chef Jason. I'm gonna continue this. I want you to try it, and because I'm not gonna be sharing. See ya.
Chef Jason Peru was brought to you in part by